Dislocation of elbow joint. We take before extension type of subarachnoid fracture. I ask you a little question. What is the differential diagnosis of extension type of subarachnoid fracture? This. Posterior dislocation of elbow. And we take a table with the main difference between extension type of subarachnoid fracture and posterior dislocation. And we said before in this table that dislocation of elbow joint is much more common in adults, and the commonest dislocation is posterior dislocation. Posterior dislocation of elbow is much, much more common than anterior dislocation. What is the etiology of posterior dislocation of elbow joint? The same trauma of extension type of subarachnoid fracture, which is fall on outstretched hand with the elbow slightly flexed, so that the action of the trauma and the counteraction of the trauma meet at the elbow region. But in posterior dislocation of elbow joint, there is mechanical block anteriorly. Anteriorly, this bone, which is called coronoid process, make a mechanical block which prevent posterior dislocation of ulna. Therefore, very common in posterior dislocation of ulna to be associated with fracture of the coronoid. If coronoid fracture occur, this facilitate dislocation of ulna backward and posteriorly. This is the coronoid process. And sure, if there is fracture with dislocation, this is called fracture dislocation. Anterior dislocation is the reverse. Anterior dislocation is like flexion type of subarachnoid fracture, which is fall on the flexed elbow. Fall on the flexed elbow like that, so that the trauma from posterior to anterior will lead to anterior displacement of ulna and the anterior dislocation of elbow. But also here there is a mechanical block. What is the mechanical block which prevent anterior dislocation? This bone, which is the olecranon. Therefore, in anterior dislocation, it is very common to be associated with fracture olecranon followed by anterior displacement of the ulna, which means anterior dislocation of elbow. Therefore, in posterior and anterior dislocation, there is association of fracture coronoid process in posterior dislocation or fracture olecranon in anterior dislocation. What is the complication of this dislocation? As we mentioned before, fracture dislocation. And around the elbow, it is very common nerve injuries. In posterior and anterior dislocation of elbow, injury of median or ulnar nerve may occur. Radial nerve is very, very rarely affected. Also in front of the elbow, brachial artery. Injury of brachial artery is rare. And in this dislocation, sure, stiffness of elbow joint may occur. And elbow region is one of the famous sites for myositis ossificans. What is the clinical picture of posterior dislocation of elbow joint? Sure, posterior dislocation is much, much more common. Posterior dislocation is much, much more common, and this is characteristic. the olecranon process is prominent posteriorly, more than normal. In the rare dislocation, which is anterior dislocation, sure, the olecranon process is displaced anteriorly. Sure, in posterior dislocation of elbow, the olecranon process is displaced posteriorly or anteriorly. Therefore, what is the relation between the three bony points at the elbow? As we mentioned before, in extension type of subarachnoid fracture, normally the relation between medial and the lateral epicondyle and olecranon is a straight line on extension, and the equilateral triangle during flexion 90 degree of elbow. In anterior posterior dislocation, the olecranon is displaced forward or backward, leading to disturbance between the relation between the three bony points, and no straight line during extension and no equilateral triangle during flexion. Also, never forget to examine distal pulsation to exclude compression or injury of the brachial artery. Never forget sensation and motor examination to exclude nerve injuries. What is the differential diagnosis of posterior dislocation of elbow joint? As we mentioned before, extension type of subarachnoid fracture. Plain X-ray is characteristic. Show the displacement of olecranon backward or forward in anterior posterior dislocation. What is the treatment of posterior dislocation of elbow joint? Posterior dislocation, the treatment usually close the reduction and external fixation. Close the reduction under general anesthesia. Traction is applied on the slightly flexed elbow, which is the deformity. The patient comes with slightly flexed elbow. Traction to relax the muscle and pull the olecranon forward. Opposite the olecranon fossa in the humerus. Sure, in any traction on the slightly flexed forearm, counter traction by assistant on the arm. Traction is applied by one hand. And where is the other hand? The other hand push the olecranon into the olecranon fossa. Like this. Counter traction on the arm, traction on the forearm, and push the olecranon into the olecranon fossa. This maneuver can be done in the prone position. One hand produces traction on the flexed forearm. And in this case, the counter traction is made by the bed. And the other hand pushes the olecranon into the olecranon fossa in the normal position. External fixation by above elbow cast or posterior slab for 3 weeks. And the early mobilization is essential to avoid stiffness. In anterior dislocation, as usual, closed reduction and external fixation. Open reduction and internal fixation for fracture dislocation. Open reduction and internal fixation is only done in fracture dislocation. But if there is no fracture dislocation, it is enough closed reduction and external fixation by posterior slab for 3 weeks. This is the posterior dislocation of elbow. Thank you for good listening and good luck.